How are we going, everybody? We're back at the lemon tree here. I'm gonna take this off this spalier to see if I can work out what's going on with the root system. Well, actually, you know what? We should dig it up first. We'll dig up around the base before we start pulling it apart. Because what I'm looking for here now is to see if it's wet underneath, if it's sitting in water still. Look, it's a raised garden bed. You can see it's elevated on the other side. But needless to say, this was flooded out somehow. When the pipe burst, the water wasn't going anywhere. And there's a lot of mulch here. See all that white stuff there, mycelium? That's a good fungi that's telling you that the bark is breaking down, so that's great. I think this is part of the problem. There's too much bark here. That's another thing we should all factor in when we're mulching our garden beds in wintertime, especially. You don't want, you know, 4 or 5 inches. 4 inches of bark, 70 mils, 75 mils, okay. But any more than that can cause it to hold a bit too much moisture, and that's what it looks like it's doing here. Let me just go on the other side. So I'm just gonna pull the bark back first. Like that, get some airflow back in there. I said I was gonna pop this up, and I'm in two minds of lifting it. I'm just gonna dig away a little bit away from it to see what's going on over here first. I'm using the garden fork because it's a safer way to get down to the roots without chopping them away. That's pretty good, actually. See, it crumbles away. So you form a ball, beautiful. And just break it away like that. So it's not wet. Look, no dirt on my hands left, and really, so it's not muddy. If it was really muddy, my fingers would be full of it. So we might just dig a little bit closer. I think what we need to do here is just aerate it like that, scratch the surface. And sometimes that's more than enough. Let's see if we can see any roots here. Yeah, look, we're pulling up the roots. See that there? I can feel it as I'm dragging it through. Ah, hear that? It's like I'm slicing them away. There they are. So there's the roots of the tree. So I've just cut some off. No. I don't need to dig this up. Why I'm saying that, because see how it's dry? It's nice and dry. That's all we need to do. This is what you've got to do with all your trees. If you've got a tree that's really yellowing, A, it needs to fertilize. B, it may be sitting in wet feet, and the only way you're going to know is by doing what I just did there. It didn't take long, did it? Just pull the mulch away a little bit. Using a garden fork, I've just loosened up the soil. You dig down to the side of it as close as you can to the trunk or to the roots, that is, without disturbing them too much, because you don't want it to go backwards any more than it is already. And then aerate the soil all the way around, which is what I'm going to do now. And see how I'm doing that? Just punching the fork into the ground and just slightly turning it just to break the crust. And I'm going to leave the mulch off this so I can get some airflow. They need to drain well. They need to breathe well. Citrus trees need that. They hate the cold, they hate the wind. I get that, but you know, I've got other trees, and you saw them yesterday, they're doing fine. They're doing great. This one here, and I know it's not super wet, and you're gonna say, well, if it's moisture that's killing it, why are you gonna fertilize it? Well, I need to get something into it. So at least if I do use any moisture like water, I'm gonna add my liquid gold to just stimulate the root system or the microbial activity that's meant to be down there below in the soil, so that the tree in return can take up the nutrients it needs to green up. Now, you can apply a dry fertilizer, blood and bone, pelletized manure, like a dynamic lifter or rooster booster or anything like that. Black root's not needed at this one. On those ones here, yes, because they're doing mighty fine and they'll love the calcium and the phosphate. Here we need to get the ammonium back into the soil, the nitrogen, ammonium, so we can green up the leaves and stimulate some new growth. So the liquid gold in the EK Butch combined, in this case here, is a great way to do it. As I was saying earlier, the dry fertilizers are great to apply as well, but you need to moisten them so that they can dissolve and work their way through into the soil. So whether you apply a dry one one, whether you apply a wet one, it doesn't matter. Either way, they both need to be hydrated. Well, that's already hydrated, but what you need to do is make sure that it drains away well. So good drainage is important. I pulled the mulch away here, so I'm hoping this is going to breathe well. And do that with any tree in your garden or any plant in your garden. Half the time we over mulch, and that's great in summertime. We want to keep the beds warm, cool and moist, but in wintertime, if it holds too much moisture, and I should have done this a long time ago, my own fault, you know, I can't remember everything, and it's just common sense and practice. Pull the mulch away, let it breathe, and liquid feed it, dry feed it, and fertilize it, and water it in, and it should green up. And that's not going to happen overnight. It's going to take probably a month to 2 months before I start seeing any results. And by then, as the weather kicks into the warm season and it goes up in temperature, the tree should react quite comfortably as well. So fingers crossed, we have some success. So the Eco Butch and Liquid Gold. And for those of you who like messaging me and saying, Vasily, if that's how you measure, we're in trouble. I've done it for about 30 years. I think I know what I'm doing by now. If you're not comfortable, use a measuring cup, use a spoon, use a tablespoon, use a ladle, whatever you like that you can use it as a measurement, use it. That's how I do it. It works for me. All right, this is one tree that didn't work, and it wasn't because of the liquid feeding. It's because of the moisture. Yep, it's draining. See that? It's just pulling up there a little bit. Let's see if it goes. Give it a couple of seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, yep, it's going away. You can also, this is what I love about the liquid fertilizers, you can either use an easy hand spray and apply it on with a spray, or just apply it straight over the top like that. All right. So we're coming into the season to feed our trees. It's vital that we do feed them well. Sorry, you know what I'm looking at here? See the graft union at the base where they're grafted on? So the top half is the actual fruit variety or the citrus variety. At the bottom, it's the rootstock. You can see it's quite a larger diameter in the base by comparison to the trunk. And the same on the others. Well, look at them. They're all about 2 or 3 inches above ground, about 50 to 75 mil above ground, which is traditional what we do with all planting. Have a look at this one. This one I buried a bit deeper. Now, I've heard in recent times from other tree growers saying it's okay to bury the graft below the surface. I've never done it before, and actually I think this is the first time I did it without thinking I've done this. And now this may be another problem. Maybe the problem, we don't know. But at the moment, let's just work with this theory that the mulch was too thick on the top, it wasn't breathing well, excessive moisture, we've just liquid fed it, we've aerated the soil, we've given it a nice foliage application of fertilizer. And let's sit back and see what happens, eh? We'll come back and monitor this, and we'll go and check out our tomatoes, and I've got a new grafting tool to share with you tomorrow. It's grouse. You're going to love it. From me, Vasily, Maresi. Now, check out our website, vasilysgarden.com. Our specials are running all the way through, you know, through the COVID period and all the lockdown period. 65% off all products online. The black grid is 70% off, so enjoy that. Take advantage of it because it's time to feed your garden, and it is time for me to play with my puppies because I've been out in the garden all day. They've been locked up. From me, Vasily, Maresi. Come on, mate. Hello. All right, good timing. Let's go.